Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're in Northeast Africa checking out some of our older equipment. So they have an older 16-inch by 12-inch hammer mill here that feeds down onto one of our 4x8 shaker tables. And then behind that, they have a smaller 12-inch by 9-inch hammer mill that they've been running into one of these APT gold catches. And they've been having really good luck processing both raw ore from the mine, as well as recovering mercury and gold from the tailings from the current wet pan mills, which you can see behind in the distance there. Here's our 4x8 shaker table, and now we've adjusted it so the fall is a quarter inch per foot towards the tailings trough, and the grooves are level, parallel with the grooves. So here's the inside of our 16 by 12 hammer mill, and the hammers are brand new. They're the an older style high chrome hammer, and then there's the screen, the lid here.
The nuggets are inside the Mercury.
So here's some very fine gold that was recovered from the tailings. Right at the sunset, we're losing our light, but we're going to try and smelt these concentrates from the shaker table today. And right now we have them roasting over a fire, or the furnace actually, and there's a little bit of water that's boiling off, and we're going to roast them real good and get them all oxidized, and then mix them with some borax and smelt them in a little crucible. Okay, now the sun's gone down and we've roasted our stuff. It's in the furnace in a small, probably a number 2 crucible, maybe a number 3 crucible. We don't have a cone mold here, so we're going to use a bar mold, tipped at about 45 degrees to try and get a cone down in the corner. This is going to be our little cone mold here. It's probably a 5-kilogram bar mold, and we're going to tip it about 45 degrees and pour it down into that corner. And we've got this steel pan in case any of the slag overflows, which it's going to be close. I think it might. But we'll catch all the slag, and hopefully our gold will go right down to the bottom in the cone. So our smelting kind of worked. We didn't have a proper cone mold, and so we ended up getting all these little gold beads instead. And so they're going to work on making a cone mold, and then all the gold will collect down into one single bead instead of flowing out and mixing into a bunch of little tiny beads. So, you know, we smelted the sulfides, recovered the gold. It just isn't in the shape we want. So they're going to work on getting a cone mold and should do better for them. So last night after we left, this guy re-smelted our fine gold beads and made a little cone, and he recovered 2 little beads of gold. So just by kind of judging off the cuff here, that's probably around 1 gram or maybe a little bit less. So this is, as far as I know, the first successful field smelting test of mercury-free gold. So that's pretty cool. Here we're at the gold buyer and we're weighing our gold. Looks like it's about 0.5 gram. The scale doesn't go down to a very accurate weight for that little bit of gold. But yeah, we recovered 0.5 gram from, what, 2 sacks? Not very many sacks.
Yeah, 200 kg maybe?
Yeah. So we're at one of these cone mill sites. And we noticed these guys are all covered in soot. So we came over and asked them what they're doing. And at the mining site, they stack tires up against the vein and light the tires on fire to heat up the vein, and it cracks the vein. And then they bring the rock down and put it in these cone mills with about 1 kilogram of mercury to recover the gold. But all the tire ash comes with the ore, and you have bits of tire and rubber and all the rubber chemicals that get mixed in with the ore. And then out here is their tailings pond, and it's just a tire sludge pond. It's just full of tire ash. I've never quite seen anything like this before. But this has got to be one of the most toxic mining practices I've ever seen. Not only do you have the mercury, but now they're burning tires that are full of hazardous chemicals. We've moved to another site farther north in the country, and they're also running a 16-inch by 12-inch hammer mill down onto one of our 4x8 shaker tables. And the customers are testing the recovery of our shaker table and hammer mill against some of their sacks of ore, comparing it to the wet pan mills in using mercury. And what they found is our system recovers about 2 to 3 times more gold than the wet pan mills in Mercury, which only recover about 30 to 40% of the gold, whereas we can recover about 85% with our table. Here you can see the gold collecting in the top 3 grooves of the table, and once it cascades down into the 4th groove, it works its way up onto the cleaning plane under the water bar, and then down into the number 1 and number 2 port for final collection and smelting. Here's a shot of some of the fine gold against the black mat of the shaker table, and you can see just how fine it is. Here's a shot of the gold in a gold pan with a little bit of sulfides, and then the final product here after smelting. And this final picture is me holding a 10 kilogram gold bar. This is by far the most gold I've ever held in my hands at any one time. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.